On our second day in Marsabit, we were invited to another community. And they surprised us with a traditional song and dance to welcome us.
We really welcome you and feel at home.
And of course, it didn't take long before we got invited to join them. And I was amazed by the beautiful handcrafted jewelry that they were wearing. And we were actually lucky enough to receive them as a present. And of course, by then, I was totally integrated.
They are the owners of this site.
Yes.
And the main purpose of this one is to practice FMNR.
FMNR, farmer-managed natural regeneration, is a method of replanting impoverished and deforested soil. This technique is so special because it relies on reviving local trees instead of planting new ones. Everything that is needed for this innovative method are underground roots of old plants that are basically revived. Through systematic regeneration and care by the communities, the roots will turn into trees again and other plants can grow in their shades. Eventually, deserts actually become forests again.
So Wild Vision came to the community and helped them to conserve the environment so that they can use it, transform them. These mothers have been trained on how to prune, how to manage these trees so that they can be able to grow faster and be able to provide pods and flowers. So because their goats now are healthy, they have milk. Their mothers are able to have milk and then be able to breastfeed their children well. And they also have nutrition, improved nutrition because of FMNR.
Where's your city?
Okay. Sueño cuando era pequeño, sin preocupación en el corazón.
We also got a glimpse to another kitchen garden that enables women to grow vegetables like spinach, potatoes, and carrots. Before that, they would only focus on cattle breeding. So now they also trade with vegetables to generate their own income. Besides, drought-resistant food will help those people through future dry spells.
And then these are spinaches?
The spinaches.
And they come, first they come in the shape of these little ones, right?
Yeah, they are nursery. In fact, we first have a nursery, mm-hmm. Then after 3 weeks, yeah. We transplant from the nursery to now the seed bed.
Oh, okay. Mm. After 3 weeks.
So if you have three technologies. One is the stone gardens. Mm-hmm. You have the bucket gardens.
Yeah.
And then this is the vertical bag garden.
Vertical, yeah.
Vertical bag garden.
Okay.
So it uses very small space.
Mm-hmm.
Like you can now plant vegetables within these halls.
Ah, okay. Good.
So the capacity of this bag is 100 plants.
100 plants.
It's 100 plants. You also have for 280.
So she's thanking all of you for coming and see what we are doing here.
This community has been trained in harvesting gum from trees, which they sell on local markets. That way, they have an extra income besides their livestock.
It's amazing to think that this ground here, which is like very beautiful red sand, can be fertilized, and then suddenly you have all this background full of leaves that is food for their livestock, and then they don't have to go away hundreds of miles just to find some new food. So I think they're doing really good work, and it's really helping. Especially you see the results.
The impact of FMNR is astonishing. The crop fields have doubled, and the income of the families has increased. The constant improvement in healthcare and education will give these children a true chance of overcoming poverty and hunger. So if you want to know more about FMNR, click on the link below.